Hi folks, CodeTutor here, and my name is Anil Deshpande. Welcome to another video on solid principles, where we have been trying to understand the various solid principles and what it means to violate that principle. In the previous video, we have seen the violation of LSP, that is Liskov substitution principle. And before that, we had seen OCP, that is open and close principle. And we had started with SRP, that is single responsibility principle. It is now time to progress to the next one, which is ISP, that is interface segregation principle. Well, what do you mean by interface segregation principle? Let's have a look at the official definition. The definition is: clients should not be forced to depend on interfaces they do not use. Well, there are some keywords here, keywords like interfaces, clients, and what do you mean by depend? So even before we try to understand the definition itself, it is very, very important that we understand these keywords, that is interfaces, clients, and what does it mean to depend on these things. So let's take an example of an interface called teacher. It has a stub function called function teach. Well, there will be a concrete class which implements this interface. So you have a class called science teacher which implements teacher and then provides the implementation of teach. In the same way, there could be another class, math teacher, which implements teacher and once again overrides the function teach. So in this case, both the science teacher and the math teacher are the implementing classes of the interface teacher. So both of these are clients of teacher. There could be another relationship of client, which is not a direct implementation of the interface. Take for example, a class called school class, which takes an argument of list of teachers and then has a function called start class. It iterates over teachers and invokes dot teach function. In the same way, there could be another class called teaching schedule. Once again, it takes an argument of the teacher interface. Both of these classes, that is school class and teaching schedule, don't implement the interface teacher, but they use the teacher. So they are dependent components of the teacher interface. So now let's go back to the definition. When I say clients should not be forced, what I basically mean is the implementing classes and dependent components should not be forced to depend on interfaces they do not use. It's time to see what it means to violate this principle. So let's take an example of printer interface. It has three functions: print document, scan document, and fax document. And then you have a basic printer which implements printer interface. A basic printer prints the document, so that's perfectly fine. But the basic printer doesn't scan the document or fax the document. But because it implements printer interface, it is in a way forced to provide the unnecessary implementation by throwing unsupported operation exception. This is a clear violation of interface segregation principle. So the printer interface is trying to do too many things, and that has a domino effect on the class that tries to implement that interface. Let's take another example. You have an interface called animal, which is trying to do too many things like fly, run, and swim. Now we have a class called dog that implements animal. Well, dog can run and swim, so that's not a problem. The problem is when you try to make it fly. But we are kind of forced to implement that interface because we are implementing the animal interface, which violates ISP. Let's take one more example, interface vehicle. You have a class which implements vehicle, aeroplane which also implements vehicle, and boat which also implements vehicle. You can already see there are problems here. Taxi cannot fly and sail, aeroplane cannot drive and sail, and in the same way, boat cannot drive and fly. These are pretty straightforward to observe. But there is another indirect mechanism where it can create a problem. Let's assume that we have a class called Vehicle Manager, and that takes the argument of vehicle interface. Now, if somebody passes a taxi here during the actual usage of this Vehicle Manager object, then taxi throws unsupported exception in the fly function. In the same way, it will fail sail as well. So now I hope that you have a broad understanding of what it means to violate interface segregation principle. Now let's try to understand an example with respect to Android application. Assume that you have an interface called user operations with three stub functions, that is fetch user profile, authenticate user, and logout user. And typically in Android application, you also create view models. Let's assume that you have an authentication view model that extends view model and implements user operations. Because it is an authentication view model, it is perfectly fine for this particular view model to implement authenticate user and logout user. But fetch user profile looks out of place for this particular class. In the same way, let's assume that you have a class called user profile view model, which once again extends view model and implements user operations. Once again, fetch user seems to be perfectly fine for this particular view model, but it is forced to do the implementation of authenticate user and logout user because it implements user operations. And this is the problem that you will run into if you are not careful about how you are designing your interfaces. To really nail the point, let me show you an example where, let's assume that you have a worker interface that has eat function. If it is a human worker, this should look perfectly fine. But what if it is a robotic worker? For a robot to eat, it doesn't look right. So when you are creating interface, initially it may look like it is well suited to implement that interface or provide a definition of interface with certain set of functions, but pay attention because you might inadvertently create situations where a robot might end up drinking a soup. So that's it in this video. In the next video, we will cover last principle of solid principle, that is dependency inversion principle. So stay tuned. Brings us to the end of this particular video. Don't forget to like, comment, share the video, and subscribe to the channel. Take care. Bye.